This is a small table saw sled, and I use a sled like this all the time, but I don't have one for this saw at the moment, and I thought I'd see how long does it actually take to make one of these if I wasn't filming it. So I'll just leave the cameras rolling while I'm making it, and I'll edit it afterwards, and we'll see how long it takes. I've got a clock right there.
I got most of my materials ready ahead of time to try to make this build go a little bit quicker. And here's a piece of Baltic birch that's just about the right size. I just need to make one cut on it. Two pieces of 2x4 will make the front and back fences. I just need to cut them to the right width. I should add that I squared and straightened these on a jointer before I started filming. And now I need to cut them to length, and the length that I need is the same length as the width of the piece of Baltic birch plywood I'm using. And now I'm actually cutting them to width. I changed my mind before and didn't cut them. And now to make the runner. I normally make that sort of thing out of exotic hardwood, but I thought I'd try plywood this time because I always ran into problems with the wood getting a little bit wider so that the sled got too tight in the summer. I figure with plywood I have much less of that problem. The plywood I'm using here is actually plywood that is maple layers throughout. I don't know where you could buy that sort of thing. I got this out of a piece of scrap from the garbage. And I'm shaving this down, making narrower and narrower cuts until it fits in the slot just right. Now the plywood is a little bit thicker than it needed to be, so after having cut it to width, I'm actually ripping it down to the right thickness. And now to attach that runner. The runner needs to be a little bit further from the edge as it is from the slot to the blade. And I'm just clamping that on for now, and measuring that distance, and then measuring slightly further on the wood itself. And with the two C-clamps on there, I can go ahead and drill holes for screwing it on. Now, normally I would be attaching this runner mostly with glue, but because I want this video to go fast and I don't want to wait for it to dry, I'm actually just screwing it on for now. The drilling left a little bit of chip out on the wood, so I'm chiseling that off before screwing it on there. Just checking that the camera is still recording. And now cutting the first edge, and also flipping it over, and making a slight cut from either end so that I know where the actual slot for the sled is going to be. With that first cut made, I know that this edge is exactly parallel to the runner, so I can use a big framing square to make sure that the fence is going to be perpendicular to that. And I actually have great faith in framing squares. I've never had one that was out of square. And now with the clamps removed, I'm just checking for squareness again, and then without the clamps, I can go ahead and put the rest of the screws in. And now I'm using pretty much the same procedure to get the other fence on there nice and square as well. And repetition is not that exciting, so I'm playing that back at 16 times speed. And now cutting off the excess length of the runners.
Well, my plan has been foiled because this camera stops recording after 20 minutes, and the one I'm holding was supposed to go for 40 minutes, but it stopped after 23 minutes.
and I didn't check the cameras for a while, so I've actually gotten a lot further on this sled than is in the film. What I've done since then is I cut the slot through here, and I took these things off again because I forgot to plane the bevel into here. And I made this block here that goes right there, and that is to protect me from getting my fingers cut, because as I push this through, the blade comes out here.
And that block is going to get glued on, and if I'm gluing that on, I should also glue on the fence that it attaches to. Glue bottle's plugged up, drill undoes it really quick. And now I'm going to have to wait for glue to dry, so I figured while I'm at it, I might as well glue on that runner now. So just unscrewing it, putting some glue on there. Damn glue bottle. Spraying that out a bit so I don't get too much squeeze out. And to put it back on, I'm putting one of the screws in first so I can just put it on the point of the screw so I don't end up smearing it around as I place it. And again, since I have to wait for glue to dry anyways, I might as well glue on the back fence as well. I have a little bit of a glue squeeze out that went into that small bevel that I planed on the edges of those rails. I don't want glue in there because that needs to be a space for sawdust.
While the glue dried, I looked at what I shot, and basically this basic sled took about half an hour to build, and after that I just kind of got into finer details like beveling edges, cutting corners and such. There's one thing that is not part of a sled like this that I really like, which is to have some sort of stop that prevents me from pushing the sled past the middle of the blade. And I already made some prototype of a little flip stop that goes here like this. So I'll make that again out of some nicer hardwood. This shape is tricky to figure out. I just do it trial and error, which is why I made a prototype. So it'll pivot on a nail and it will catch like this, but it also needs to not catch on this little slot here.
Now just marking where the hole needs to go. And I always like to put a coat of varnish on my jigs because that way they just look nicer and they don't get dirty so easily. And I really don't have a need for painter's triangles either.
So even if you like big fancy table saw sleds, you should still make yourself a simple one like this, because it's not much work to make one. Only problem is, at that point, you'll hardly ever use a bigger sled because it's just so handy to put aside when you're not using it. And this is actually the fifth sled I built like that. This was the first one I made just for cutting some puzzle pieces, and I realized it was so handy, I decided to make a video about making one like that, and that was this one, at which point I decided I could use this one for dados. And then I made this one for my homemade table saw. I made this one for the DeWalt table saw, and now this one.